baby, all city, nigga. No doubt, baby, all city crew. Ready to flip shit and coming through with the crew. No doubt, baby,
like
all
that,
city crew. Ready to flip shit and coming through with the crew. No doubt, baby,
best all city
crew. Guys, what is up? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. Sample Shopping is back. This is going to be a good couple episodes. Actually going to be 4 episodes over the next 8 weeks, and we got some good stuff to go over. All of the stuff you're going to see here is available on decantshop.com. Use that coupon code MAX12. It'll save you 12% of your entire order. I started using that coupon code in 2012. So that just shows you how long my relationship with decantshop goes back. It goes back to 2012. And this is a brand that I really believe in. So everything here available there. Great selection, great prices, great service. Use that coupon code. Let's get right into the fragrances from decantshop. First one is from the house of Abercrombie and Fitch. It's called the First Instinct Extreme. Now, I only own one from this house. That is Fierce. And I think that's all I ever want to own or will need from this house. But we're going to look at this one, Be Fair, which was a 2019 release, so pretty recent, from perfumer Philippe Romano. This is the first perfume I've ever smelled from him. And online, you can get this one between $20-$40. And note-wise, we're going to get mandarin leaf, pepper, star fruit, Sichuan pepper, violet leaf, cardamom, saffron, suede, musk, amber, cashmere wood, and coconut milk. So definitely like the star fruit and coconut milk play here. And as far as this fragrance goes, man, this is just horribly disappointing. It smells like everything else out there. It's ambroxan and it's generic fruits. I suppose there's going to be people that enjoy this. You can guess what kind of fragrances those people will gravitate towards too. But it's just really boring for me. It's fruity, it's ambroxan, it's ISOE super. It's boring. I could never see wearing this. I wouldn't recommend wearing it. It will make you smell fine if you wear this. You might get a compliment or two. That's the nature of ambroxan. But you'd have a hard time picking this out from many of the fragrances that pollute our market right now. So it's not a winner for me. Hopefully better next up. And next up, we're going to the house of YSL. This is Kouros Silver. I own 7 bottles from this house. I really enjoy YSL. Not their most recent stuff and Loam Flankers, but I like the older stuff. And I still need to get Opium, Brome. I need to check out the original Jazz. I haven't smelled YEDP, to be fair, but I think we know where that's going. I'd like to get Noble Leather. I'd like to check out Tuxedo, the whole niche color, their whole like upper line, and like Sleek Suede and Velour Vinyl. So a lot of work to be done with YSL, but the only one that I know that I want is Opium Perome. This was a 2015 release that you can find online for about $30 to $35. Perfumers here, Olivier Pichot and Michel Girard, and the notes here are apple, sage, woods, and amber. That's it. It's a little better than Abercrombie, a little bit. But it's kind of the same thing. It's just kind of that, that just very much designer fragrance. I don't smell apple, sage, or I smell a little bit of wood, but I don't smell apple or sage. Yeah, it's just very nondescript and non-impressive. I'm sorry, guys. We're very much 0 for 2. I would wear this. It's nothing to do with the original Kouros, which is a favorite of mine. So let's move on. I think we're going to have some better luck with the last two. First up from the house of Serge Lutens, this is Ambre Sultan. I own 3 from this house. Fille en Aiguille, Chergy, and 5 o'clock Ocean Jambe. There are quite a few that I'd like. Borneo 1834, Muscou Blancan, Araby, Jeau de Pau. Just so many that I need to try, from Santal Maja School to Iris Silver Mist to Fumery Turk. You know, there was a Chris Sheldrake prime period, and there's just a lot I want from that prime era. You know, I think the brand has gone a little a little bit weird by having these 100 ml bottles and charging very expensive prices for them. But, you know, this was a 2000 release from Sheldrake during that golden era. And note-wise, we get coriander, sandalwood, bay leaf, patchouli, angelica, resins, myrrh, amber, oregano, myrtle, benzoin, and vanilla. And you could find a bottle of this online for about $70. So very fairly priced for a Lutens fragrance. And yeah, this is great. Now, I recently reviewed the Parfums Vintage version of Ambre Absolute. And I said, you know, Ambre Absolute reminds me of this, and you should sort of pick between this and Ambre Absolute, or if you want the Parfums Vintage version, which is called Sandal Ambre. And I had the Sandal Ambre version, and these three just smell remarkably alike. Very heavy on labdanum. Labdanum is the forward material for me in all three. So I wouldn't buy this because I have Sandal Ambre, and that's like, to me, 95% to this, which is 95% to Ambre Absolute. So I would recommend, if you're interested in Ambre Absolute, this or Sandal Ambre, just checking all three out and deciding which one's for you. You don't need all three, and this is the cheapest of the three, to be honest, at $70. A really nice amber fragrance. My issue is that it's just so labdanum dominated. I kind of find it to be a little bit boring, but it's a good fragrance. And then finally, we're going to look at one from the House of Guerlain. This is from the Aqua Allegoria collection, which has a lot of gems. Don't sleep. Called Flora Nymphea. I own Flora Nymphea. I own 10 bottles from Guerlain. I want many more. Shalimar, Vetiver, many that I want to try that I still haven't. Such a great house with such a range of prices as well. And this was a 2010 release from their wonderful Aqua Allegoria collection. Terry Wasser is the perfumer. And notes on this are green notes, red berries, orange blossom, honey, syringa, musk, and woods. Bottles of this now, you kind of have to get on eBay. You're going to pay about $100. As many of these Aqua Allegoria scents are limited, and not many stay, like Pompaloon and Herba Fresca seem to be at this point. But yeah, it's a really nice floral fragrance. Like, for me, I think it's definitely too feminine for me. It smells feminine. Everyone can wear what they want. It smells like a woman's fragrance for me, but it's really beautiful. It's just a really beautiful floral. It's a little bit green. You can smell that orange blossom. It's almost to the point of indolic without being indolic. You know, the red berries sort of make a little bit of a whisper in this one, but mainly it's green, orange blossom, maybe a little bit of honey, a little bit of some berry notes. Just a beautiful women's fragrance. I think if I was a woman, I would find this very classy and I'd want to wear this one. All right, guys, so if I'm ranking these, I'm going Guerlain 1. I think this is the best of the four that I've smelled. Clearly, Ambre Sultan 2. I would pick the Kouros 3, even though I do not like it. And Abercrombie and Trash number 4, just not a good fragrance. Would I purchase any of these? No, I wouldn't. But I think if you like amber fragrances, Ambre Sultan is worth a look. And if you are into florals, I think Flora Nymphea is definitely worth a look if you can find it. It's a really good floral fragrance. So guys, next week, 4 more on the docket. We'll look at one from Hermes, one from Caron, another one from Guerlain, and one from CB I Hate Perfume. So some French classic brands and then a very new modern brand. All of these available at decantshop.com. Use my coupon code MAX12. I'll see you again real soon with more videos. It's handsome, 7-digit figures, and some. We're back at the mansion, we light up the Branson and write hot shit to leave you dancing as we advance on through all city. Ready to flip shit and coming through with